Okay, Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So in the previous videos, I have introduced to you the diode rectifiers. Okay, so after the diode rectifier, you will get a rectified output like this, right? And then you want to go through another circuit known as the filter circuit, where it's going to smooth out the rectifier output. And after that, another section from part 3 is voltage regulator, where eventually you will get a DC output voltage that is going to be supplied to your electronics devices. Okay, so let's look at the filter circuit. So if you look at this circuit here, when there is no capacitor connected, it is just a standard half-wave rectifier where you will get this output, right? So now a capacitor is added in parallel with the load resistor, okay? And then at first, there is no charge across the capacitor, alright? So during the first quarter of your positive cycle of your VS here, okay, your VS is connected here, eh? Okay, the diode is fault bias, at which when your VS start to become bigger or equal than V gamma, right? So the diode will turn on and the current will flow and it will charge the capacitor. Okay, so you can see this arrow here shows that it is charging the capacitor, right? So the output voltage of your capacitor will be equivalent to the output voltage of the half-wave rectifier. V out equivalent to Vs minus Vd, okay, that we have learned in the previous video. Okay, so let's say your Vd, we use model 2 where your Vd equivalent to V gamma, let's say 0.7 volt, and let's say the sine wave Vs is 5 sine theta, right? So your V out will be equivalent to 5 sine theta minus 0.7, right? So V out peak will be equivalent to 4.3 volt when your Vs peak is 5 volt. So the V out peak is equivalent to the capacitor voltage peak value as well, right? Okay, so I hope that's clear. So that is the peak value here of your output and capacitor voltage. So now, the second quarter of your positive cycle, as Vs falls back towards zero and into the negative cycle, the capacitor discharges through the resistor R because the diode is reverse bias or turned off. Why is this? Okay, so now you can see that when that happens, the capacitor discharges through your R. So actually what happened is that this node before it start to discharge is 4.3, right? The peak value, okay? And let's say as your sine wave here moves towards negative cycle, from 5 volt, it goes to 4.9, for example. So what is the voltage difference between these two nodes that will provide the V gamma? So Vd is equivalent to 4.9 minus 4.3, which is 0.6 volt. So this value is less than V gamma. Our V gamma is 0.7, right? So the diode does not have enough voltage to turn on. That's why the diode is off, right? And then the sine wave continues to go to negative cycle, where we know the diode will be reverse bias. So that is why there is no charging of capacitor occurs, okay? Because current cannot flow. So the capacitor discharges through your R. So if the RC time constant is large, the voltage across the capacitor discharges exponentially, okay? So we know that the diode is off when your Vs moves towards a negative cycle. And then in the next positive cycle, there is a point at which the input voltage is greater than the capacitor voltage and diode will be forward biased again. So for example, as the capacitor discharges from 4.3 volt, okay, so let's say it discharges to 3.7 and your Vs increases until 4.3. So what is the voltage difference? Is 0.6, which is still not enough, right? Then the capacitor discharges again until 3.65 volt and the Vs increases to 4.35. What is the difference? It's 0.7. So this is where your diode starts to turn on. So the capacitor will stop discharging, and because this diode is on, your current can flow and your capacitor will be charged again, right? The diode remains on until the input reaches its peak value, the 5 volt just now, and then the capacitor reach its peak value as well, which is the 4.3 volt. So let me illustrate. So this orange graph is going to represent the capacitor's voltage. So the first positive quarter cycle, okay, and when your Vs reaches theta 1, it reaches the value where it is equal or bigger than 0.7. The diode will turn on and capacitor charge up. until its peak value. So in this example, it was 4.3 volt, right? And then the diode turns off and the capacitor discharges through R, okay? And this is the equation that it takes when it discharges. So Vm is the peak value of the capacitor voltage, the 4.3 volt just now. So it discharges until it reaches a value where the value of Vs allows the diode to turn on again, as I mentioned in the previous slide. So the capacitor will be charged up again because the diode is foot bias, right? So it is charged up until it reaches the peak value again and discharges again. So the process continues. And because you can see that the capacitor filters out a large portion of the sinusoidal signal, it is referred to as the filter capacitor. So that's how the filter circuit works. Okay, so now let's look at the ripple voltage. So ripple voltage is the voltage measured between the point where the capacitor discharges to its lowest value up to its peak value. So that is known as the ripple voltage. So let's consider T prime to be the time of the capacitor to discharge to its lowest value, which is from this point to this point, okay, which is this one. Okay, so this is T prime. And the period of your sinusoidal is known as Tp. So in this figure, the period is measured from the peak value here and the peak value here of the sine wave, and that is the period, okay? So this is the equation to calculate your ripple voltage. And if I factorize it this way and we expand the exponential in series, you will end up having this equation, okay? So this is the equation of Vr, where your T prime is this time, the time of the capacitor to discharge to its lowest value. Okay, so if the ripple is very, very small, to the point where this value here is very close to, let's say, this point, okay? So you can approximate your T prime to be Tp, the period of the input signal. So if that's the case, then you will have Vr equivalent to Vm Tp over Rc, which is this equation. So this is the equation where you assume that your T prime equivalent to the period Tp. Normally the question will give you the frequency of your sine wave. So you know that period equivalent to 1 over F, right? So you will end up having Vm 1 over F over Rc, and you will have this equation here. This is the ripple voltage for half wave rectifier. So for full wave is very simple, because you know that the diode will turn on during both cycle, positive cycle and negative cycle. So the capacitor will discharge and charge at every half a period. So you can see here, okay, this is half a period, and therefore the Vr equivalent to Vm over 1 over 2 of your period, and the period is equivalent to 1 over F. You will have this term here, Vm over 2FRC. This is for your full wave rectifier. For half wave, is Vm over FRC. Okay, so that is the equation for ripple voltage. So next, I will show you some examples to calculate the ripple voltage. So in this example, consider a full wave center tap rectifier. So look at the keyword. So the keyword is full wave, alright? And then the question gives you all these parameters, and you are asked to calculate the value of the capacitor. So the capacitor is connected in parallel to a resistor. You are given the input voltage that has a peak value of 120 volt. Okay, so that's your Vs, and the peak value is 120 volt. The frequency is given as 60 Hz. And this sentence here, the output voltage cannot be lower than 100 volt. So I will show you what it means. And you are given V gamma, 0.7 volt. And you are asked to calculate the value of capacitor. Okay, so when you are asked to calculate the value of capacitor, based on this equation, so you have your frequency, your resistor, and you don't have two things. You don't know what is Vr and you don't know what is Vm, right? But so this sentence here, the output voltage cannot be lower than 100 volt, is the clue. So this is the charging and discharging of your capacitor voltage, right? Okay, so what it means by this sentence is that the lowest point is 100 volt. That's what it means by that sentence. The output voltage cannot be lower than 100 volt. So, in order to calculate what is Vr, you need to know what is Vm, the peak value of your output voltage, right? Then only you can calculate what is Vr. So, you need to calculate Vm first, by calculating V out peak. So the V out equation equivalent to Vs minus Vd, right? And you are going to use model 2 because you are only given the turn on voltage. So 120 minus 0.7 equivalent to 119.3 volts. So this is your Vm, the peak value of your capacitor or your output voltage. Okay, so then you can calculate what is Vr. Vm minus the 100 volt is 19.3 volts. So this is your Vr. So now you have all the parameters for you to calculate capacitor. So if you put all the values, you will get capacitor equivalent to 20.6 microfarad. Okay, so for example 2, again is a full wave rectifier as well. You are given the capacitor value, the resistor value, the input voltage is given as Vs equivalent to 50 sine 2 pi 60 t. So this is your frequency. Okay, 2 pi ft. Right? You are also given V gamma equivalent to 0.7 volt, which means that you're going to use model 2, calculate the value of the ripple voltage. So let's look at the equation again. Don't forget this is full wave, so you need to use this equation here where you have the 2. So you know your frequency, you know your resistor and capacitor, so you need to calculate what is V out peak or Vm, right? So again, this is a bridge rectifier. So the equation for bridge is V out equivalent to Vs minus 2 V gamma. Why? Because it goes through 2 diodes, right? So you can see here, don't forget that V out equivalent to 50, which is your Vs peak. Vs peak is 50, right? 50 minus 2 V gamma. So I have 48.6 volt. So put it inside this equation and you just straight away calculate your Vr. Okay, so that's the answer for my ripple voltage. So this final example here, again, is using full wave rectifier circuit and it's a center tap circuit. You are given the output peak current, okay, which is 200 milliampere, and the peak output voltage. Okay, so your Vm is 12 volt. Alright, the input supply voltage Vi is 120 volt RMS, the frequency is 60 Hz, and V gamma is 0.7 volt. Find the required value of capacitor for limiting the output ripple voltage Vr equivalent to 0.25 volt. Okay, so this is the equation for the ripple voltage for full wave. You already know what is Vm, Vr is given for you, the frequency is also given for you. So the only two parameters that are unknown are R and C. The question asks you to calculate C, right? However, you can find what is R using Ohm's law, because if you look at the circuit here, the voltage across R is known because it is the output voltage and output voltage is given as 12 volt. The current I is the current flowing through your circuit here, and it's the same current because it is in series. So R is equivalent to V out over I, and you will obtain R equivalent to 0.06 kilo ohm. So you just put the value here inside the equation and you can find what is capacitor. The capacitor is 6.67 millifarad. So that is the end of the filter circuit. The next video will be about the voltage regulator circuit using Zener diode. So I will see you then. Bye. Assalamualaikum.